I'm your host, Darren Capozzi. You guys are in for a treat. Have a seat. Have a seat. I'm so excited to bring up this guy. Not only is he a national headliner who tours the country performing at colleges and clubs, he's born and raised in Memphis, Tennessee. You've seen him on hit TV shows such as Off the Chains, We Got Next, and Punchline. He's also in a new movie, brand new movie with Damian Dash, called Dressed to Kill. Guys, give a round, warm welcome to my boy, Memphis Will!
Y'all go ahead and sit down. How y'all doing? Yeah. Listen, I thought the host did an amazing job of introducing me, but I just happened to notice in my spirit as I was walking toward the stage that nobody really gave a fuck. The shit was so disrespectful that I gotta reintroduce myself, because when I came up, I was looking at the front row and I was looking at him and I saw him clapping with his motherfucking ankles as I was coming to I was like, I know this ain't what my career have came to right here, nigga. This motherfucker don't give a fuck, nigga. They put anybody in an audience. As soon as this nigga got on a stocking cap at the show. You don't believe in COVID, you cover up your face and your head, huh? He like, you won't sneeze on me, nigga. I'm covering up. So I'm gonna reintroduce myself. We're gonna get that popping. Is that cool? Destiny Child, that's cool. En Vogue, that's cool. Lil Wayne, that's cool. Stocking cap, you ready? B2K, you ready? Yeah, got his B2K shit up. Y'all don't see me. Start clapping, start clapping. From Memphis, Tennessee, at the Comedy Cube, put your hands together for Memphis Will! I told the exec to Comedy Cube that I do my jokes according to how much he's paying me. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. The special money has ran out. But here's actually, man, I'm trying to settle down and find myself a wife. That's what I'm trying to do. Yeah. Who relationships made it through the COVID? No, no, no. Y'all made it through the COVID? I mean, y'all really love each other, yeah. My shit broke off the first week. No, because a lot of people don't know your relationship is over when your woman start counting the food. Because I had my woman wake me up at 3 a.m. I thought the house was on fire. She was like, get up. And I jumped up. I'm like, what? She was like, did you eat 3 grapes last night? She's like, before I went to bed, it was 33 grapes. I just grabbed my suitcase. This relationship is over. She's counting the bananas and the apple. The relationship is over. No, but I'm trying to find me a wife, man. That's what I'm trying to do. Is church a good place to find a wife? So I noticed we got different spirits in the room. Let me tell y'all a good place to find a wife. If you want a woman that will make love to you in 24 hours, and she's wifey potential, pay attention. I just seen one guy stop hugging his woman. He was like, hold on. Let me see what he's saying. You have to go to Food for Less on Crenshaw and Central. Go between the first and the fifth. They're gonna have a few kids, but fuck all that. Just play with them kids a little bit. Wee! And you fucking that knife. Now let me say something to you. They not the sharpest knife in the drawer. So before you go to Food, because I just seen a guy laugh and put it in his phone. He went, Food for Less, Crenshaw and Central. First and the fifth. I seen them, I ain't gonna point them out. Before you go to Food for Less on Crenshaw and Central, let me say this here to you. They not the sharpest knife in the drawer. They not like Walmart or Whole Food or nothing like that. Wish I was making this up. Food for Less, Crenshaw and Central. Just met a girl today. Destiny Child. Watch this. Can't make this up. B2K. Watch this. Can't make this up. Too young to be in a relationship. Watch this. I can't make this up. Wade Cap. I said, how you doing, sweetheart? I'm Memphis Will. What's your name? She said, Keisha. She said, Memphis, you got some really sexy dimples. I said, thank you, Keisha. She said, how long you had them? You ever talk to somebody that make you dumb? Because now I got my ass in the store like, how long have I had these before? It's a good ass question, Keisha. Let me ask my mama. Mom, boy, get the fuck off my phone. Click up. Same girl. Y'all think I'm playing. Same girl. Keisha said, why do they call you Memphis Will? I was like, well, Keisha, I'm born and raised in Memphis, Tennessee, but I've been in Cali for the last 15 years. She was like, so have you ever been to Memphis? I said, I know I just told this bitch I'm born and raised. Y'all think I'm bullshit. Keisha said, listen, Keisha looked me in my eyes. Keisha said, I can never go back to Tennessee because they too racist. She said, last time I was down there, they was calling me and my friend, color girls, color girls. I said, Keisha, don't worry about that. The next time you down there, you need to visit the city of Memphis. Keisha said, I go to Memphis, but I'm never going to Tennessee again. I said, Keisha, if you can go to Memphis and skip over Tennessee, you're a special motherfucker, Keisha. And I gotta pick a wife from that generation, see. So let me show y'all the power of energy, because a lot of y'all just don't know the, if you're in a relationship, clap your hands. Relationship, clap your hands. Single, single, clap your hands, single, son. It's the people with the excited energy. That's that stress-free energy right there. Till they get lonely around December. Now, a lot of y'all don't know you are with the people you with because of energy. Y'all don't know the power of energy. I'm finna teach y'all the power of energy right now. Watch this. What's your sign, beautiful?
Sagittarius.
Sagittarius? I want you to pause. You have really good edges. What's your sign?
Aquarius.
Aquarius? Here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna show y'all the power of energy. I'm gonna look you into your eyes. I'm gonna break you down on national TV. And if I'm right about you, me and you will exchange contact and go on a date. But after I break you down, I'm gonna turn and break her down. Just in case your shit does not work out with you. You got to rotate. Can't put all your eggs in one basket. Now, give me Sagittarius.
Yes.
Look me in my eyes, because I have to feel your energy. You ready?
Yes.
You have a good heart, a good spirit. You're a great observer. You see through guys and girls. However, you can be very sensitive, affectionate, emotional, and you have a very high sex drive depending on who you're dating. Be sure I get that number before you leave. She was like, be sure I get that number before you leave. Aquarius, look me in my eyes. You ready? You have a good heart, a good spirit. You're a great observer. I don't give a damn what your sign is. I tell everybody the same shit. I'm a Pisces. You got a good heart, a good spirit. But I'm a Virgo. You got a good heart, a good spirit. I was killing them in college with that shit. You got a good heart, a good spirit, a great observer. Oh, you just understand a bitch, huh? Look, he's trying to remember my shit. Look, you gonna go home and fuck it up. You got a good forehead. Pretty sideburns. What the fuck is you talking about? Let me ask the ladies this. Do the ladies cheat?
Yes.
So we got a few honest ones. Look at the rest of them. I'm gonna go. Do fellas cheat?
Yes.
Now all y'all wanna participate now. Let me tell y'all something. It's no such thing as an insecure man until a woman make him insecure. Look at the ladies, I don't give a fuck. Fuck that, he was born Ike Turner. Look at Beyonce, like fuck that, he was Ike Turner when he came out. Let me explain, let me make myself clear. When a man meets you, he's very excited about you. He's walking through the mall. He's holding your hands. Y'all going to Six Flags together. Sir, you done dug all up your nose. You a nasty motherfucker. Digging up his nose and laughing. This motherfucker's disgusting. Don't nobody shake his hand after this. I can tell you. That motherfucker come that motherfucker some way by the camera, man. If it's a booger laying on the camera, it's his nasty motherfucker. I was in the middle of my shit, he went, yeah. Ha ha ha. Snatched. Snickers up in boogers in the audience, man. What happened to the old school, nigga? Go down your pants leg with that shit, man. Snickers said, fuck that, I'm gonna hit it on this special. Bop. Feel something sticky in that back row. Oh, that's why you're sitting by yourself. It's all making sense now. You've been digging up your nose all night. Nigga, come to my special, I'm gonna go up my shit. Fuck that shit. Now, here's what I'm talking about. Here's how you know, ladies. So this man is walking through the audience, holding your hand. He's feeling all good. I said audience. This man walking off through the, grocery stores and mall. He's confident because he just met you. But along the relationship, ladies, y'all do things that make him insecure in time, and you don't even know you're doing them. So the spirit has led me here to share with you. What happened is, he's walking through the mall, he's holding your hand, and you see some guy you used to know. So you let go his hand, and you run your ass over there, and you get this guy a hug. Now, if you hug a guy that's unattractive, for some reason, you come back and explain him. Oh, that's my brother. We went to school together. We grew up together. He's dope. He's cool. You're like, oh, okay, no big deal. We didn't feel insecure to him anyway, so it didn't make a difference. You didn't have to explain that. The problem is, this 6'8", curly green eyes, in shape guy, so you let go our hand and you go hug him. And then you come back and grab our hand and you don't explain who he is. And now we got to pretend we confidence, waiting on you to bring it up, but you ain't brought that shit up yet. Now we driving home and we gotta say some shit like, so who was old boy? Cause the spirit got to know who he was. And then you say some shit like, oh, that's like my brother, we grew up together. You be like, that's funny, I ain't never seen him at a barbecue. But here's why I'm saying this, ladies. If you let go your current man hand to go hug your ex, it's disrespectful. Now pay attention, because this is where you make him insecure at. Because the only thing the guys want to know, if you were sexually active with him. That's all we care about. Because if you let go his hand, pay attention, fellas, because the ladies don't know they do this. The next time she let go your hand, and if she go hug a man sideways, and she come back and tell you they friends, believe her. But if she let go your hand, look at the fellas, they done leaned up and shit. If she let go of your hands, I want you to watch her feet. And if she hug him and go on her motherfucking toes, they used to fuck. And if she hugging him and hold up one leg, they still fuck. Let me show you the difference. Used to fuck, still fuck. Look at Wade kept having a flashback. He done text this girl, bitch, who was that nigga you was hugging in 1983, bitch? You look like a ballerina, bitch. She didn't do it, please. She was on her toes because he was tall. Now, here's like I say, this is why I got to find a wife. So I tried to find my wife in church. How many of y'all go to church? Just two, okay. I want everybody to be able to participate. How many of y'all heard of church? Listen, I've been in California 15 years and I never went to church. So, true. You say what? If you're scared, go to church. Yeah, you must be like, what, 25? What's your sign? You a what now? No, no, when is your birthday? What's your birthday? Look me in my eyes. You got a good heart, a good spirit. So listen, I've been in church, I've been here 15 years and I never went to church. So right before the COVID, one of my comedian friends, they called me, it was like, Memphis, if you're gonna stay balanced, you have to go to church. True story. So he took me to a church in Compton, California. How many of y'all been to a church in Compton? Okay, just one digging up his nose. Don't use that hand for nothing. He gonna hold up his hand. So that booger done been on tour. That booger done been in a few church benches. He done had people go to church. Ew. Why this Bible got a booger in it on the book of Job? He done left boogers all through the Bible. Nasty motherfucker. So listen, so my homeboy took me to church. A true story. He took me to church in Compton, California. If you have never been to a church in Compton, I want you to take time out and look at me right now. You are not missing anything. Jesus do not go to Compton on Sunday. And before y'all judge me, let me make it make sense. Got to the church, I can't make this up. Five people was in the church. Y'all think I'm playing? Right before the COVID, his daddy was the pastor of the church. That left four people. His mama was singing in the choir. That left three people. Destiny Child, watch this. Can't make this up. SWV, watch this. Cameraman, watch this. Booger Man, watch this. I just can't make this up. B2K, watch this. Young Relationship, watch this. Zach, watch this, Zach. Can't make this up. His brother was a deacon. Ladies and gentlemen, two people sitting in the church. Me and the guy that invited me. I can't make this up. Do y'all know the pastor of the church, his daddy stood up and said, God told me that somebody gonna join the church this evening. Executive producer, watch it. Try, I'm looking around like I'm the only visitor in this motherfucker. This is clearly a family organization. He leaned over and whispered in my ear, he said, Memphis, you gonna have to join the church or my daddy gonna keep on preaching. Security, watch this. I leaned back. I said, nigga, I'm not joining your motherfucking church. Y'all think I'm bullshitting. His daddy heard me tell his son that I'm not joining that church. On my mama, rest in peace. His daddy had a flashback, turned into a gangbanger in the middle of the church service. Y'all, B2K, I'm not bullshit. B2K, his daddy came out the pew, walked directly up to me and said, young man, somebody gonna join this church today. And I put that on blood. I said, I hope it's Jesus' blood. While I'm joining the church, Rent-A-Center came in and started taking everything. I told my boy Trife about it. I'm not bullshitting. Who paid 10% tithes? I'm sorry, wrong question. Who heard a 10% tithe? You ever paid your 10% tithes and thought about what you could have done with the money? Just me. You ever got ready to pay your tithes, felt like the Spirit told you to keep it? God said, you've been good this week. Go ahead and keep that for yourself. Because let me tell you something. If you go to a black folks church when it's time to pay tithes, what's the first thing the pastor say? Will a man rob God? Not in Compton. He used psychology. Same pastor held up the church light bill and nicknamed it the devil. He said, we're going to get rid of this devil today. We're going to be baptizing our new member in the dark. It's up to you, saints. Wade Cap, I looked at the light bill. I said, hold on, man. This is your house light bill. This ain't even the church light bill. He said, you can get the fuck out of this church. I can't make this shit really happen. Y'all think I'm bullshit. This shit really happen. I only tell real stories. Now, here's another thing I don't like. I know the older guys, they're not going to like this, but I'm going to do it anyway. I do know, I no longer like, we got, it's a 2-cough minimum, and sir, that was one. So on your second one, go ahead and escort yourself outside. Don't make nobody have to tell you. If you feel that second one coming on, go ahead and leave the church. Go ahead and get out of here. Now, listen, true story. I can't make this up. I was saying something. What the fuck was I just talking about? That's what, no, I wasn't on no light bill, was I? Oh, guys, that's what the fuck I was on. Niggas yelling out shit, not even paying attention. The light bill. I was 10 minutes ago, nigga. It's a trifling ass. The light bill. Your grandmama. B2K in the wing cap. The five heartbeats. This nigga just yelling out shit. Got nothing to do with nothing, goddamn. So listen. I no longer like to see, and I apologize in advance, I no longer like to see older guys dating younger girls. Here's why. Look at the old guys like, man, the fuck, I'm done with this show. Look at the old guy. Fuck what he talking about. I'm gonna get me a young bitch. Fuck what you talking about, Nick. Kiss my ass, younger motherfucker, you. Let me see. Here's why. One of them niggas took my motherfucking woman coming out of college. So as you can see, I hate these old niggas with a passion. Because here's what happened. Because y'all are a younger crowd, so I want to teach y'all something. See, when you come out of college together, you and your lady supposed to experience life together, because when you experience life together, when you go through something and you make it through the storm, your relationship and marriage will last. So if y'all keep going through the storm, your relationship gonna last. But you have to keep in mind that woman has a good heart and a good spirit and a great observer. Every time she get mad, look at her in the eyes, you got a good heart, a good spirit, a great observer. Now, so when I come out of college, you're supposed to experience life together. Pay your mortgage, pay your car, no, pay your insurance. But this old motherfucker, he was paying my girl rent, a fucking car note, her fucking insurance, and she got mad with me. She was like, why in the fuck can you pay my bills like my older friend? And I was like, first of all, bitch, he got a 40-year head start. How the fuck I'ma compete with a retired military check, man? You can't fuck with that military check, man. It's over for your ass. And so ever since that happened to me, I have been hating on older guys. Well, younger girl, I was in Walmart today. It was this 65-year-old man holding hands with like a 23-year-old girl. My spirit said, hate on him. Y'all think I'm playing? So I got behind him in the line and I started singing, dance with my father again. He didn't give a fuck. He started dancing. Come on, keep singing, motherfucker. Yo, fuck, what you talking about? And so I did a show last night. True story, in the front row, it was a 75-year-old man with a 23-year-old girl. And I knew he would have to use the restroom in 5 minutes, because you know they can't hold AP. Them old niggas gotta get to that bathroom. So as soon as he got up, I said, sweetheart, why are you with a 75-year-old man? She said, well, first of all, he lied about his age, and he told me he was 40. And I can respect that, because these old niggas trying to look young. They putting on jewelry, they putting on shades, they got these Bluetooth covering up their hearing aids. Y'all see these motherfuckers. Y'all see these old niggas with sweatsuits on trying to look young. Nigga got the Adidas sign on Stacy Adams. I ain't never seen no Adidas church shoes. I was like, nigga, them Stacy Adams, take that goddamn Adidas sign you just stitched on that motherfucker. Now, here's the thing. So I told her, and I want all the ladies in here and everybody watching, if you want to know the age of these old men, if you want to know if a man is 60 and up, I want you to pay attention. The next time he take you out on a date, I want you to watch his hands. Because if he sat down and started massaging his knees, this motherfucker is 63. So they don't even know they doing it. Look, they just, it's automatic. When they sit down, they got to grab their knees. I don't know what it's for. Now, here's the thing in California. This is what I have learned. Any other state in the world, if you're interested in taking a young lady out, do you know the only thing you have to do is say, excuse me, are you single? And if she say yes, no, y'all exchange contact, you build rapport, you're gone about your life. But in California, listen up, fellas, pay attention. You got to ask two questions, because the second question can save your life. First question, are you single? Second question, you better follow up with how long you been single. Wait, cap, pay attention. B2K, pay attention. Booger hand, pay attention. Exec, pay attention. Can't make this up. I can't make this up. Insane, watch this, pay attention. In sync, I say insane, goddamn in sync. In sync, pay attention. Sir, you don't have to hug her the whole show. We know y'all together. Every time we look that way, he squeezes her tighter. She been watching the show in the headlock the whole time. I want to participate, but this motherfucker is choking the shit out of bitch. He got Ike turned to tendencies. Got to watch him. So the first question is normal. You say, are you single? But you better follow up with how long you been single. True story. As soon as the COVID end, I took a young lady to the movies. I can't make this up. As soon as I sat down, some guy started kicking the back seat of my fucking chair. Boom! Boom! And every time I try to turn around, she would say, no, 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 no. Stop, just ignore him, watch the movie. Boom! So now I'm frustrated. So I leaned over and said, do you know this motherfucker? She said, yes. It's my ex-boyfriend. We just broke up 2.5 hours ago. Boop. Boop. And now I'm thinking, this bitch is trying to get a nigga killed. I said, how in the fuck do he know where we at? She said, I told him I'm with my new man, Row One Theater One, a Southern gentleman. Boop. Now, y'all know I couldn't continue to let this motherfucker kick the backseat of my chair. This is a true story. So I said, fuck all this comedy shit. I said, if this motherfucker kicked my chair one more time, I'm about to embrace my gangster spirit. This is a true story. Sure enough, boop. I immediately jumped up. I was like, look, motherfucker. Ladies and gentlemen, when I turned around, this motherfucker was 6'9". With a P90X body with the word Crip tattooed on his forehead. I immediately realized in my spirit that he does not give a fuck about life. But the problem, executive producer, is I had already aggressively said, look, motherfucker. Now I got to finish this shit. Destiny Child, I'm all in. Now, Wake Up, I'm all in. NSYNC, I'm all in. I ain't got nowhere else to go. SWV, I'm all in. B2K, I'm not bullshit. Cameraman, Booger Man, this is what I did. I was like, look, motherfucker. I'm going to the concession stand. You want anything back? Fruit punch or popcorn or anything? I came back and sat next to him, and we both start kicking the back seat of her chair. I was like, bitch, what's wrong with you? This nigga got a good heart and a good spirit, bitch. He's a good Crip, bitch. Hey, I'm Memphis Will, man. Thank y'all so much.
This has been a Funny Media Group production.